HIV is the human immunodeficiency virus. If you have HIV, you have an infection that damages your immune system over time and causes AIDS. AIDS stands for Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. It is the final stage of an HIV infection when your immune system is damaged and too weak to fight off ordinary infections. When foreign invaders, such as bacteria and viruses, get into your body, they can cause infections. These events activate your body's defenses. The white blood cells of your immune system are part of your body's defenses. One type of white blood cell, called helper T lymphocytes or helper T cells, strengthen your immune system's response to infection in two ways. First, helper T cells release chemicals that attract other white blood cells to the site of the infection. These additional white blood cells attack the invading bacteria or virus, as well as other infected cells. Second, helper T cells release chemicals that cause other white blood cells to multiply. These new white blood cells create markers, called antibodies, which can identify the same foreign invader throughout your body. Antibodies attach to the bacteria or virus, marking them as targets for your immune system to destroy them. If you have HIV, it travels through your blood and other body fluids to infect and kill certain white blood cells. The virus enters helper T cells, which are the primary target. Once inside, the virus makes many copies of itself. As these virus particles are made, they leave the damaged helper T cell to infect other cells. The T cell loses its ability to protect the body from the ongoing infection and dies. In this way, HIV spreads and kills more of your helper T cells, weakening your immune system. As a result, other types of infections are able to take advantage of your body's inability to defend itself. These infections are called opportunistic infections. If you have an HIV infection and one or more opportunistic infections, you have AIDS.
Virus by unsafe sex, contact with blood of an infected person, for example by using a contaminated injection needle, from mother to child during pregnancy, childbirth or breastfeeding, because the virus is transmitted through blood, sperm, vaginal fluids, pre-seminal fluid, breast milk.
Network. Your sexual network is a big picture of yourself, the people you've had sex with, the people they've had sex with, and so on and so on. If any one person in your sexual network has HIV, everyone else in the network runs the risk of being infected. If your sexual network is large, there is a greater risk that the people in the network will spread HIV. Saliva, tears, or sweat do not contain HIV. You cannot get HIV by touching, holding hands, kissing, sharing dishes, or the toilet.
The infection passes through four stages. In the first stage, the body can show signs of disease like continuous fever and swollen glands. While some people who are infected remain asymptomatic in their first stage. In the second stage, recurring airway infections, skin, mouth, and genital lesions often occur. In the third stage, you may have complaints like prolonged diarrhea, excessive weight loss, tuberculosis in the lungs, and other serious infections like meningitis. Finally, besides serious infections, the nervous system may be affected in the fourth stage, which can result in motor loss or AIDS-related dementia, It may take 5 to 15 years before you know that you've got AIDS. This is because sometimes it takes longer for symptoms to occur. HIV and AIDS can be treated with medication but can't be cured. Antiretrovirals slow down the multiplication of the virus but doesn't kill it. To support the treatment, AIDS patients often get medications to boost the immune system and fight against...
What should you do if you are HIV positive? It is normal to feel shocked or sad, angry or afraid, or a mixture of these feelings. It is important to get help from trusted people. Seek advice from your healthcare provider and others you trust as you consider how to share your HIV status with family, friends, and sexual partners. Tell the people that you have had sex with that you are HIV positive so they can be tested too. On when you should be tested next based on your personal risk factors. No matter what, having sex with men 5 or 10 years older than they are more likely to get HIV. Being drunk or using dacha or drugs before having sex may cause people to take risks that they may regret later. How can I prevent the spread of HIV? Use a condom every time you have sex. A condom works by stopping the exchange of sex fluids by forming a protective barrier. And why be tested for HIV? Many people who have HIV look completely healthy and may not have any symptoms for the first 5 years or more of their infection. They can still pass HIV on to others. Being tested is the only way to find out if you have HIV. It is very important to know your HIV status. You should have an HIV test while you are still healthy. Waiting to test once the HIV has already made you sick makes treatment difficult. Who should be tested? Everyone who has ever had sex should be tested. If you're having sex, even with just one person, you should be tested at least once a year. You should also be tested for HIV right away if you're having sex with more than one person. You suspect that the person you're having sex with is having sex with someone else. Or if you're pregnant, so you can protect yourself and your baby. Why is getting tested so important? If you have HIV but don't know it, and do not get tested, or do not get treated, you may only live for about 10 years after getting infected. Most people will suffer from many illnesses. You may even pass HIV on to your loved ones without knowing it. Worst of all, if you die, your children may not have anyone to look after them. If you know you're HIV positive, you can get medicines called ARVs that can help you live much longer and help decrease the spread of HIV to others. How is the HIV test done? The HIV test isn't nearly as scary as many people think. The test is quick, safe, and easy. The process is quick and simple. Your finger is cleaned, and a brand new needle is used to make a small finger prick. The needle is only used once and then thrown away. The rapid HIV blood test only takes minutes to give results, so you soon know your status.